Good morning, everyone. Some people make the world special just by being in it. And I, Tanvisha Goyal, on behalf of Birla Balika Vidyapeeth, feel extremely privileged to welcome all the special people, respected principal ma'am, coordinators, science department teachers, and the enthusiastic audience. You have truly graced this auspicious occasion of National Science Day by your valuable presence. We dedicate this day to the achievements of the women scientists of our country and many more budding scientists of our school too. Every brilliant experiment, like every great work of art, starts with an act of imagination. So my dear colleagues, in the 21st century, STEAM is the way to progress. STEAM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, Arts and Mathematics. These all disciplines, when put together, make a perfect recipe of sustainable growth and development. Our country is known for the great scientists and mathematicians who have made groundbreaking innovations and have made a world a place to exist so comfortably. One such legend of India was Dr. C.V. Raman. His discovery of the molecular diffraction of light on the Raman effect won him the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1930, making him the first Asian to receive the honor. In recognition of this great discovery, 28 February is celebrated every year as National Science Day.
Hello everyone, I am Mishika Goyal and she is Pragya Raj Purohit from Birla Balika Vidyapeeth, Pilani, and we are here to share our knowledge and observations about Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder which is caused by the degeneration of dopamine-producing neurons present in substantia nigra located in midbrain. It is also known as idiopathic or primary Parkinsonism. Dopamine helps us to have interest in things, to find interest in things and strive focus. The first clear report was given by James Parkinson's in the year 1817. There is no proper cause or particular cause of Parkinson's disease, but genetics, environmental factors and various other lifestyle factors affects it. Genetics is the main cause of Parkinson's disease. There are almost 10 to 15% of cases which is caused by genetics itself. Various other factors like gender and age also plays a vital role. The people above the age of 50 years are more prone to have disease, and males have the higher rate of Parkinson's disease than females. There is no proper cure of Parkinson's discovered yet.
Parkinson's disease affects nearly 10 million people every year. Parkinson's patients suffer two kinds of symptoms, motor and non-motor. In motor symptoms, we observe tremors, stiffness or rigidity of muscles, slowness of movement, also called as bradykinesia, and then we have trouble with posture balance and body-mind coordination. Also, then in non-motor symptoms, we get to observe sleep disorders, constipation, anxiety, and many more. After a long period of research, we conclude that it is highly possible to reduce tremors with physiotherapy. But again, the issue arising here is the patients cannot visit the physician regularly because they are not advised to drive, nor to climb the stairs, etc. And neither it is possible for the physician to attend each and every patient personally. In order to solve this problem, we are here with our project device PROMEC. PROMEC is a smart wearable glove which helps the physician to provide physiotherapy from the ease of their home or clinic. Here you will see a pair of clips which will help you to get the concept more clearly.
Thank you.
In the clips above, the arm is totally robotic, whereas we will be creating a wearable one. Also, the connections were wired, but we aim to provide wireless connectivity. We are still researching on the connectivity part, so as to how we can provide a good amount of range for the connectivity of the gloves. We expect to reach the final product very soon with the constant support of Birla Balika Vidyapeeth and the ATL labs, that is Atal Tinkering Labs at Birla Balika Vidyapeeth Pilani. Our project is also selected for the second phase of Children Innovation Festival 2020 organized by JUSIC in collaboration with UNICEF.
Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Khyati and she is Priyal from Birla Balika Vidyapeeth, and today we have prepared a model using our Atal Tinkering Lab. The model is known as Farmohand and it is based on the principle of ultraviolet radiation and obstacle sensing and instrumentations.
Farmohand is a project carrying the main objective to help the farmers protect the crop from damage caused by animals as well as divert the animal without any harm.
It is designed to detect the presence of animal and send a warning signal to the farmers.
As soon as any stray animal trespasses, the sensor secured boundaries will send signals to the controller as well as farmer, which causes the buzzer to produce beep song and RGB lights starts flashing.
Now we will show you the demonstration. Advantages of Farmohand include, it reduces direct conflicts between the farmers and wild animals diverting into the farms. It ensures safety of both humans as well as animals. And it increases the popularity of the farms and saves the time of the farmers. Thank you so much.
Hello everyone, this is Tulasi Vatsala Karampudi
and Mahek Pandya
of 11th grade from Birla Balika Vidyapeeth. We are here to demonstrate how a 3D printer works. What is 3D printing? 3D printing is, or additive manufacturing, is a process of making three-dimensional solid object in which the object is made by using different layers. We can see different layers separately. 3D printing is just the opposite of subtractive manufacturing. In subtractive manufacturing, a piece of metal or a plastic is hollowed out of the earth using a milling machine. 3D printing enables you to produce complex shapes using less material.
How does 3D printing work? It all starts with a 3D model. You can opt to create one or download it from a 3D library. There are many different software tools available, from industrial grade to open source. Tinkercad is free and you can open it in your browser. It has beginner lessons as well as built-in features which allows you to export your model in a printable file. The next step is slicing. Slicing is basically slicing up your model into hundreds to thousands of different layers. This is done with the help of a slicing software. Once your model is sliced, it is ready to be fed to the 3D printer. This can be done with the help of a USB SD card or a Wi-Fi. Your model is now ready to be 3D printed layer by layer. 3D printing encompasses many forms of technologies and materials. It is important to see it as a cluster of diverse industries as well as a myriad of different applications. A few examples are consumer products, industrial products, dental products, reconstructing fossils, replicating ancient artifacts, as well as reconstructing evidence for forensic pathology.
What are the advantages of 3D printing? 3D printing allows rapid prototyping. That is, it has the ability to design and manufacture an object in less time. It is cost effective and more flexible than traditional methods. It is eco-friendly and help us to sustain the environment.
These are some of the 3D models that have been printed in our ATAL Tinkering Lab.
Thank you.
Hello everyone. Today we are going to demonstrate our project Smart Safety. The main objective to make this project has been taken after a deep thought given to the increasing accident rate, which has costed so many lives so far. Many car accidents have been taking place due to weather-related issues, especially in foggy weather because of reduced visibility range. So, the ultrasonic sensors proves to be advantageous in this case.
The working of smart safety. Ultrasonic sensors have been programmed to sense the motion under the range as the waves are emitted. They get reflected when they hit the target and are received back. This is the point when the beep sound is produced, so that the driver can be aware of the approaching obstacles, especially in the foggy weather. Advantages are, this system is not very complicated and would be pre-installed. It can be adapted by the drivers in a short span of time. Installation of ultrasonic sensors can reduce the accident rate to an effective level and can be nullified as soon as possible.
Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Lakshmi Bhardwaj.
And I am Akanksha Kumari.
We are here to demonstrate our project Smart Shoe, which we have made in Atal Tinkering Lab.
People who are completely blind or have impaired vision usually have difficult time navigating outside the spaces that they are accustomed to. In fact, physical movement is one of the biggest challenges for blind people. Traveling or merely walking down a crowded street can be challenging. Because of this, many people with low vision will prefer to travel with a sighted friend or family member when navigating an unfamiliar place.
The smart shoe will help visually impaired person while walking. Working. In smart shoes, sensors are installed in front part of it to detect the obstacle in front of the shoes. When any obstacle is detected in front of the sensor installed in shoes, the sensor sends the signal to the buzzer and the buzzer produced beep sound. Another sensor can be installed in the shoes for the detection of the edge.
As we know that blind persons cannot detect the depth of the stairs or edges by looking, so to fix this, sensors for edge detection are made to work in such a way that after a certain limit fixed for the depth, sensors sense the depth up to the limit and starts producing beep sound. This will help the blind person to change the direction.
Advantages are, this shoe helps the blind person to save himself or herself from obstacles, stairs and edges.
After using this kit, the blind person didn't need any helping hand for traveling small distances. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I am Lavanya Dalmia.
I am Priyanka Maruti from Birla Balika Vidyapeeth.
Today we are going to demonstrate our project Smart Bin, which we have made in our Atal Tinkering Lab. The Smart Bin is a special kind of dustbin which opens the lid automatically when an object is brought in front of the sensors fitted on the outer cylindrical of the bin. It contains the use of Arduino board, which works as the mastermind of the Smart Bin.
When an object is brought near the ultrasonic sensor, the ultrasonic waves get reflected back and gets received by the sensor, which it further transmits through the jumper wires to the Arduino.
According to the coding transferred to the Arduino, it makes the servo motor operate, which in turn pulls the string that opens the lid of the bin, thereby allowing the object to get deposited into the bin.
The advantages of the smart bin are, patients in hospital can use the smart bin that can be placed near their beds in the hospitals.
The smart bin can be used to make smart dumping place for the garbage collected from the city, instead of throwing off the garbage in the open ground and polluting the area in and around.
Can be used in cars to dump food wrappers.
Can be used to store household wastes.
Thank you.